New York Harbor, the Verrazano Narrows, and the Atlantic Ocean beyond. Almost as quiet as a mill pond. Once alive with ocean-going ships and thousands of smaller harbor and river craft. It was a commerce fed in large part by the junction of America's thriving cross-country railroads on the New Jersey side of the harbor. On the shore of Jersey City, west of the Statue of Liberty and Ellis Island, lies part of what remains of that terminal. Brown, grass-covered railroad switching yards, as well as the still remaining basin of the Morris Canal. Here, on landfill, in what was once shallow Communipaw Cove, passengers and freight of the Jersey Central, Lehigh Valley, and B&O railroads were transferred to fleets of harbor vessels known as the Railroad's Navy. As the railroads passed, so did their longshore facilities. Repair, maintenance, and support operations employing thousands of men and women. For them, their work was a way of life as well as a livelihood. For America, they were a vital part of a growing economy and westward expansion. But with growth has come change, neglect, and decay. All the facilities here are now abandoned, except one. The former Central Railroad's Marine Repair Yard, still operating as it has for the past 60 years. Huh? Since 1955, when the railroad abandoned the yard, it has been operated by the McAllister Brothers Tug and Barge Company and used to repair vessels that still work in the harbor. It is the very nature of this work that makes this yard necessary. The harbor is a hazardous place where winds, tides, and floating debris can surprise the most experienced captain, often causing damage below the ship's waterline. At the yard's edge lie four floating dry docks, which lift the boats out of the water so that maintenance and repairs can be made on the damaged hulls and propellers. The men of the McAllister Yard have begun this repair procedure hundreds of times. And experience has taught them one thing. No job will be routine. All tugboats are different, custom made for their original owners in shipyards as near as Albany, as far away as Louisiana. The floor of the dry dock must be altered for each vessel. Sets of wooden blocks are fastened together to conform to each ship's hull. After the dry dock is sunk, tugboat is brought into place and raised out of the water. So the size and position of the blocks is critical, since they will eventually support the 100-ton boat. Thank you.
burned out.
A tugboat has few standard parts. With the exception of its huge diesel engine, almost all of the tug must be repaired with parts fabricated or refurbished here in the yard shops. Machining, brazing, woodworking, punching, and forging. All this work is carried on while the tug sits high and dry, a serious financial loss to its owner and its crew. It is important that the repairs be made quickly. The 110-man crew of the yard works 2 8-hour shifts, night and day, in all weather, to complete the job and launch the tugboat again at the earliest high tide. In the spring of 1980, this yard was closed, and its dry docks moved north along the shore to Harsimus Cove. The crews have also relocated to the new yard, where modern machinery is augmenting the traditional skills of these working men. This site, including the long abandoned railroad yards, has been reclaimed as a recreational area and is now known as Liberty State Park. Perhaps one day when the park is filled with visitors, the sound of a tug is heard offshore. This working place, once called Pier 19, will be remembered.